So hey everyone, welcome again on Devish Tech Channel. I hope everyone is safe on their home because in India COVID cases are rising, and because of that only, like this video is delayed. Like I was stuck in a place where like I was away from the home, and because of that the COVID cases are rising, I had to travel back to my home, and in this process the video are delaying more because we are not getting so much amount of time to make the video and edit the video. But yeah, I hope this thing will be sorted out soon and everyone will be safe. Okay, so yeah, let's talk about this project. And in the last video we work on the login bottom seat, and as I told in a last video that after we have to start the login API creation as well. Like we have to first set up the backend, then we have to create the APIs. Okay, so in this video let's explore and let's set up the backend thing for our Myntra clone app, and let's start writing the backend code as well for the login API. Okay, so yeah, I already created the project to so we don't waste the time to setting up the pre-configured thing. Okay, so yeah, if you want to set up this thing, you have to first install the Node.js on your system. If you don't know that how to install the Node.js on Linux system and Windows system, you can find the link of that video in the description. For macOS, please go to the Node.js official documentation that how you can install the Node.js on your macOS system. But yeah, for Windows and Linux, you can find a video link in the description. After installing the Node.js, what you have to do, you have to write this command npm init, and you have to just click enter and enter, then it will automatically create the package.json file. Okay, once the package.json file will be created, then you have to install the dependencies. For my case, dependency are express.js. With help of the express.js, we are going to create the APIs. JSON web token for generating the JWT token, which will be used to authorize our app to the backend. So normally what will happen, first we do the authentication. When we click on a login button first, then what will happen that it will authenticate a user, the front end, to the backend via the credential. Then after that, backend will generate a JWT token and send back to the front end. Okay, and now that JWT token front end will going to use all the time whenever front end will interact with the back end. Okay, so that is kind of authorization. If you want to make, I mean, if you wanted to know that what is the difference between the authorization and the authentication in detail, please drop a comment. I will make a separate video on it. Okay, so now yeah, we discuss about the JW token, and the third thing is the Mongoose. So Mongoose is a kind of helper package for MongoDB. So we wanted to interact the MongoDB database. Okay, so that is a like NoSQL database. Okay, and using the JavaScript code, we wanted to interact with the MongoDB. So this is a helper package. It will help us to interact the JavaScript code directly to the MongoDB. So we don't need to write a native code for the MongoDB. We have to write a JavaScript code, and that will be taken care by the Mongoose. Okay. Then last thing is the Multer. Multer we will going to use whenever we will going to interact with the images or PDF that will require some file system related thing. I will get back to this thing later. It is not needed as of now, but it will be required for the future. That's why I have added this package too. And the last not least, the last package is NodeMon. NodeMon, I'm using it because we will going to run the server in a development mode first. So what will happen generally, like if I will not use the NodeMon, then I have to run the npm start again and again, or I have to compile the index.js file again and again using node index. Okay, so we have to run it again and again, node index, whenever we will make a smaller change. Even I will do the console log okay, then we have to create, we have to run this node index again, okay. Because of that only, we have a node mon. Node mon will, what it will do, that we will run the our backend server with help of the node mon. So whenever we will make smaller changes, okay, so even a console log or creating a new variable as well, then automatically the node mon will detect that changes and rerun the server by their own. So we don't need to write node index again and again. That's why we will going to use the node mon as well. Okay, so these are the packages, I mean dependency we are using, and yeah, you have to create a index.js file. But let me first tell you that how you will install all the dependency. So you have to use the npm I to install the dependency like express.js and multer and all. Okay, so you have to use the npm I and it will install the express.js, multer, mongoose, and I mean all the package name, the exact package name you have to put after the npm I, and it will install it and it will automatically create a node module on your project folder. Okay, so all the dependency related code will go inside the node modules. Okay, and it will put inside the dependencies folder, I mean dependencies object, okay, of the package.json file, because we installed it in a, like, not in a development mode, but for the node mon, okay, this is a node mon, we have to put inside the dev dependency. Why? Because this node mon, it will be not required once we will deploy this backend server to the actual deployment server, okay, like AWS or Google Cloud or anywhere. This node mon is not required, okay. That's why to install a node mon, just do node mon hyphen hyphen save hyphen dev. So it will install the node mon inside the dev dependency object, okay. Okay, now this is a setup thing for our backend, okay. Just after you install all the dependency, please create a index.js file. So this is a index.js file. Here we will going to write the code related to the initial routing, okay. So all the initial thing we will going to put inside the index.js file. So let me show you the example as of now. Then in the next video we will going to set up the MongoDB as well. But first let's test that everything is working fine or not, that the package we install is perfectly installed or not. Let's test it, okay. So what I will do, I will first import the express.js package to run a small server, okay. So we have to use the require and we will use the express. Hit the control S. I don't know why it is. Oh, okay, express. And now if we have imported the express.js, what we can do, that we can create a port variable as well. So suppose as of now we are working with the local host, I mean in our development mode in our own laptop. So the port which we are going to set up is the 5000 port. But whenever we will deploy the code into the deployment server, the port will come by the server itself, okay. So that thing, for that thing we have the process dot env. So it will fetch the port from the server, and if there is no port available, then we will assign the port to the 5000. Why we will require the port? To communicate between the front end and back end. So port is extremely important, okay. So if you don't know about the socket programming, please know about it, that port is extremely important. Now we set up the port as well. The next thing is we have to create an object of this express.js package. So I will create app equal to express. So remember, it's the initial setup, okay. And after creating this thing, we can tell app.route and let's put a slash. Okay, so it's a slash means a root API endpoint. I will show you that how it will look like, and dot get to create a get HTTP method. If you don't know about what are the HTTP method we have, I will put a link on the description that where I explain every HTTP method in details. Okay, and it will take an callback function. What we will tell, it will have a request and response. I'll let as of now send a JSON response and say hello all, server is configured. Okay, and that's it. Now we have created an initial endpoint to test the server, and let's run the server on a local host. So to run a server, we have to listen, okay, on the port which we created. Or we have to provide the localhost IP address. So localhost IP address will be 0.0.0.0.0. So it will run the server on a localhost along with your own system IP address. Okay, so and the third parameter will be a callback function. Okay, and here you can console log anything, and it will be run after running the server. Okay, so welcome, we are running server at port 5000. Okay, so now let's test it. And to test it, as I told that we don't need anything, I mean we don't require to run this index.js file again and again using the node index. We have to just run the node mon index, but for running the server on a node mon, I have set up a script. It's a start script, or we can set up a dev script. Okay, so to run a server on a development environment, you have to run the npm run dev. So you can set up your own script, it will not come automatically, you have to write this dev script by your own. So here I did a mistake. Here we don't need to write anything, just node mon and use the control s, and let's run the npm run dev. We got an error. Let's see what we are getting. Okay, it is saying about the port. Let me go on index.js file. Oh, we have to use the port, not a process environment. And here we are getting that this server the already running on a 5000. Okay, so there is another backend is running on a 5000. So what we can do, either we can run it on a another port. So let's run it on 5002 or 3000 will be good. Okay, and let me hit the save. Yeah, now we got it. Welcome, we are running server at port 3000. And let's hit the initial route that it is working fine or not. To hit it, what you have to do, just write the http://localhost and provide the port number. So for our case, the port number is 3000. If I will hit it, then you will find the message which I am responding over here. Hello all, server is configured. Or you can change it. Hello, and you can put a emoji. Okay, let me hit the save and let's go and let's refresh the page. Then you will find that we got it, hello, which means the initial setup is done. So in the next video, we are going to set up the MongoDB along with the login API. Okay. And before I will close this video, I will request you to please don't forget to subscribe the channel, like the video and share the video and help me to grow this channel. Okay. Thank you all. Happy coding. See you on our next video.